Hello class, Miss Grammer here, and today we are studying about the mixed up chameleon, and we're gonna create number art. This is an example of six chameleon that I did in another lesson with first graders, and we are today gonna draw a C chameleon. That is gonna look a little bit more like this, like a letter C, and the head is gonna be down here. And let's see how that goes. Okay, so this was for first grade. We're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna get a clean paper, and we already watched or read the book about mixed up chameleon. We all gonna be super duper quiet now and follow directions. Write your name, your table number is on your divider, and write today's date is 2/24, and your grade is kinder, so just write K. After you're done with that and you're quiet and you're listening, I am gonna use marker for the reason that it's easier for you to see in the video. You're gonna use pencils or crayons. If you have markers, you can embellish your painting later, but first use pencils so you can erase any mistakes. We're gonna start with writing a big C. The top of the C, we're gonna curl in just a little bit like that. The bottom of the C will get a little bit of a head, like a little oval, with an eye and a tongue. And I'll pause it if I'm going too fast. And if you made mistakes like I did here, don't worry, we can add scales and everything and fix it later. First, we're just gonna do the basic things. But don't forget, you do have to have your name, your table number, check it now that you have it, and today's date. And K is your grade on your paper. So we have a big C. And we have the head down there. So from the head, see, we're gonna connect that C to the head. From the head, we're gonna go all the way down and down and down and down and down until we meet the other part of the C. Show you that again in another color. I touched the head here, and then there was no line here. And I just went down and down all the way around the C until I made a little loop. So I would have a little chameleon tail. After that, we're gonna pretend he's got a nice little decoration going on here. And we're gonna need four legs like this with maybe two or three or four fingers, toes. One, two, three is good. And another leg. One, two, three. One, two, three. And if I'm going too fast, just raise your hand and we're gonna stop it. I'm just making a video so I can pause it. So that's the basic shape of the chameleon trying to catch the fly. Fly is right here somewhere trying to catch it. We can give him a little nose. We can give him a little bigger eye trying to catch that fly, concentrating. Give him little scale like this, crisscross, like little X's, crisscross, little texture, crisscross, like that. Wavy lines, like if it was a salamander. all little circles. You can even give him little stripes. And we're gonna get to color it too with crayons. And some stripes will be thicker, some stripes will be thinner. And if I get my crayon box, I can color even faster. I'll just take my green and I'll start coloring sections. For example, this section I'll do all green. And the opposite section all green. Every section different color. I can even turn him into a rainbow chameleon like this one. Also, I could give him sun. Sun could go all the way in the corner. Big round sun. And I can color in nicely. And take my time. Or I can use a highlighter if you have a highlighter to add more color. And do it nice and neat, color nice and neat. I'm only rushing because of the video. I don't want it to be too long. We are now at 7 minutes, so I don't want to be too long. I'm just trying to show you how pretty it's going to look like when we color it. Highlighters work really good too. Any kind of crayons work wonderful too. See how rainbowy he is in this picture? You can copy all those colors. And it looks like letter C, so we made our art today. And this type of art is called letter art or number art. You can make art out of letters, like if it was G or C or number 6, number art, number 6. It also could be letter G, kind of looks like a little letter G. And just continue coloring it very special. Use all kinds of tools that you have in your toolbox. If you have both markers and crayons, use them. They're gonna give you different, what is called, textures. You can use all of the colors that you have in your toolbox. And as I'm finishing mine, I'm going to start walking around checking your work. I hope everybody is concentrating. It's nice and quiet. Only your hands are busy. Your mouth is not busy. We're not calling out. We're not showing off our artwork yet. There will be time for that at the end of the class. We will take a class picture. You can show off your finished piece to your friends. But now is not the time. Now recoloring, making him all rainbowy, finishing him up. There's so much to do before the end of the class, and we're running out of time. I'm going to end the video so I can assist you. And now it's your turn.